I'm Jeff Bock, and I build custom bike frames. I built my first one in 1975. Just graduated from UNI. I was thrilled upon graduating to find out that the local bike shop, you know, Europa Cycles, wanted to hire me. So I went to work in the bike shop, and like I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. Got to work on bikes all day and got to ride bikes, you know, any time I wasn't working. And in almost no time at all, I upgraded my bike, where and to the point where I had a Raleigh Professional, which was, you know, the top of the line Raleigh, and I'd also acquired a really nice Schwinn Paramount, which was Schwinn's top bike at the time. And I found myself looking for the next step up, but I didn't want a racing style bike, I wanted a touring bike. And so I bought a Campagnolo tool kit, but I realized that, well, you know, actually, I mean, these are okay for a professional shop, but these are frame builder tools. And so the hot thought got in my head, is like, well, maybe I need to build my own frame. Back then, custom built lugged steel bike was considered the very high end. I mean, that was just the absolute pinnacle. At that time, you know, if you wanted to build frames, there were, you know, people would be lining up at the door. For years and years and years and years, I always had with no advertising other than just word of mouth, I always had a waiting list. What's your incentive for a custom bike? I mean, okay, just for the cool factor. Part of what you're paying for on a custom bike is a certain level of, you know, precision alignment. You know, the frame has to be straight. It has to be put together well so it stays together. Okay, I mean, that's a given. I mean, that's a basic. Now, it doesn't have to look nice to do those things, but that's the baseline. But the other part of it is, in my mind, there's no sense doing all that work to make, you know, get all the fit and the alignment right and then just not care about how it looks. You know, because part of it is, okay, this is a custom bike. You want it to stand apart from all the production bikes. And, you know, quite frankly, I mean, there's some perfectly rideable production bikes out there. If it doesn't look any better than a production bike, well, that lowers the cool factor. I think maybe I've always been just a little bit obsessive about detail. So I guess it's an attempt to up the cool factor. What I do is not inexpensive. I mean, the final product, I mean, I make almost nothing per hour, but it's still not inexpensive. I enjoy doing it, and I plan to do it for as long as I can continue doing it.